Sponsored by Kraft. Stay tuned for details on how you can win an iPhone 17 Pro Max or iPhone Air.
The iPad you know is about to feel ancient. iPadOS 26 is Apple's blueprint for how all tablets should work going forward, and it's awesome. Every few years, Apple gives the iPad another shot at being your only computer. This year, iPadOS 26 is that shot. You get the usual new design, new features pitch, but this time the differences feel much more real and tangible. We're talking proper multitasking, a files app that finally lets you organize your work, and a design update that actually makes the iPad feel new. The biggest change? It finally feels like you're in control of your iPad. Let's get started by talking about this new design, liquid glass. The new liquid glass look is less about showing off specs and more about making the iPad fun to use again. It's not a wild new color scheme or some 3D animation overload. It's just cleaner, smoother, and more responsive than anything the iPads probably had before, or at least not for a long time. The lock screen is where you notice it first. The time morphs around your wallpaper and notifications know how to get out of the way. Photos, even old ones, can turn into 3D spatial scenes that show this 3D effect as you tilt your iPad. It's subtle, but the whole thing feels more tactile and less like just swiping on your glass display. This is Apple doing what they do best, refining the details until everything feels intentional. So for the first time in a long time, the interface feels more playful and actually satisfying to use. For the most part, that's what I found. There are going to be some that will probably find liquid glass to be polarizing. I'm not one of them, but I can definitely see how the glass effects and the way things morph through the glass elements could throw some people off, or at least make it feel like things are less legible or harder to see when compared to previous versions. That said, I think a lot of people are going to like this a lot. But while the visuals finally are catching up, the real leap is in how you actually use the thing. So let's talk about the new window management. I think this is the big one. For years, iPad multitasking felt like Apple was taping features onto the side of iOS, and that's no more. iPadOS 26 tears out the old system and builds a desktop class window manager rebuilt for touch from scratch. Resize windows like you do on a Mac, but with gestures designed for fingers, not a mouse. If you want to focus on one thing, you can just flick a window up to go full screen. If you need to check notes while reading an app or article, snap 2, 3, or even 4 windows into precise layouts. Tile them left, right, top, bottom, whatever works for you. Flick down to minimize, swipe up and hold to see every open window and expose. It's all there. Even Stage Manager gets smarter, letting you organize windows into separate workspaces and then flip between them. And yes, plug in an external monitor and you get the same advanced windowing. It's not just half-baked mirroring, it's just more pixels for more apps. And this is the first time I've used iPad multitasking and thought, yeah, I could actually do real work like this. It's not something I need to remember how to turn on or invoke. But a great workspace means nothing if your files are locked away. But before we get into the Files app, which finally changes that, I promised an iPhone 17 Pro giveaway. So let's jump into today's sponsor, Kraft. Kraft is the app I rely on when I want my notes, tasks, documents, and projects organized and styled beautifully. With the new liquid glass design in iOS, iPadOS, and Mac, Kraft honestly looks right at home wherever you use it. It's one of the few apps that's actually keeping up with Apple's own design language across platforms. And what really sets Kraft apart now is the AI assistant that runs right on your device. They've just integrated Apple's own foundation models, so you can brainstorm, summarize, and organize your notes with AI, even if you're totally and completely offline. Everything stays private, on your device, and lightning fast. And if you're someone who sketches out ideas, you'll love the Apple Pencil support. You can mix sketches and text together on a single page or mark up any document, which is perfect for planning, storyboarding, or just taking fast notes that are actually fun to look at. And it doesn't matter if you're on an iPad. iPhone, Mac, Vision Pro, Windows, or the web, Kraft syncs instantly and always looks clean and consistent.
To celebrate the new launch, Kraft is giving away your choice of a 512 gig iPhone 17 Pro Max or 1 terabyte iPhone Air
in the color of your choice.
Plus, two runners-up will each receive a pair of AirPods Pro 3.
To enter, download Kraft using the link down in the description and create an account. It's completely free. Then hit the like button below and drop a comment letting me know what your favorite feature or use case of Kraft is. And that's it. You're in the running to win.
Be sure to also leave your social handle in your comments so I know where to DM you if you win.
Big thank you to Kraft for sponsoring this video and making the giveaway possible. And good luck to all you guys who enter. All right, let's talk about the Files app, because this is another feature that finally lets your iPad grow up. The Files app has always felt a step behind compared to what you get on a Mac, but it doesn't feel that way anymore. Now you get a list view with customizable columns, folders you can color code and decorate with emoji and drag and drop that works exactly how you'd expect. And one of the biggest upgrades is folders in your dock. You can just drag a folder from the Files app down into the iPad dock and it turns into a persistent drawer. Always just right there, a tap away, no matter what app you're in. And if you want to drop a file into a project, you don't have to dig through screens or tabs, just drag, drop, and done. You can finally set default apps for files, customize your workspace, and actually manage projects like you would on a real computer. And for anyone who does creative work or managing big projects, these upgrades finally make the iPad feel way less frustrating. But that's files. What about all those other little annoyances? Those why can't I just moments? Apple's next feature answers that with a simple swipe. And I'm talking about the menu bar and background tasks. One of the most useful changes is the iPad now gets a menu bar, just like on the Mac. Swipe down from the top and every command for the app you're in is right there. Searchable, filterable, and way easier to find than ever before. No more endless hunting for hidden options or unknown keyboard shortcuts. And background tasks, you can finally start something like exporting a video in Final Cut or a big AirDrop transfer or downloading a large file, and then go do something else on your iPad. Previously, if I wanted to export a video and I left Final Cut mid-export, it would just stop. Now, the process just keeps running in the background with a progress indicator in the status bar and lock screen as it should be, just like it would work on your Mac. It's the kind of update that makes the iPad feel more like a real computer. Small detail, but it actually will make a huge difference if you use your iPad or just something that's a little bit more than play. Now, does this turn your iPad into a Mac? The answer is absolutely not. I've seen a lot of people saying it feels just like a Mac now, and the feel of the Mac is there. But one thing that it's not going to do is allow you to just install software from anywhere you download it, similar to how you can do on a Mac. On your Mac, you can download and install anything you want. On an iPad, everything goes through the App Store, at least here in the United States. That said, if you ever wish your iPad could do Mac level editing, you are about to get your wish in one specific way, and that is with the Preview app. Because if you use a Mac, you know that Preview is just that one app that does just about everything when it comes to managing and editing files. So now it's on the iPad and it's the same thing. You can edit your PDFs, scan, sign, crop images, rearrange pages all in one place. You can scan a multi-page contract, sign it with your Apple Pencil, rearrange the pages, use autofill, and export in new formats right from the Preview app. If you need to pull images out of a document, you can do that. If you want to paste from the clipboard and instantly create, or you can copy an image to your clipboard and instantly paste one into a document. All of this stuff is there and it works. Preview on iPad finally brings the kind of tools Mac users have had for years. And if you're a student creator or anyone who just hates juggling a bunch of different apps just to get basic things done in your documents, this is exactly what you've been waiting for, built into iPadOS without having to download and potentially pay for a third-party app. And there are a few more upgrades that power users are going to care about. So a couple of extras that are going to matter depending on your specific workflow. First, big one for me that I was happy to see, the journal app arrives on the iPad complete with Apple Pencil support, multi-journal setup, and a map view that visualizes your memories. Another cool one, audio recording gives you pro-level control now. You can pick mics per application. You can kill background noise and record local high quality audio during calls, which is gonna be perfect for podcasting or interviews. The phone app comes to the iPad thanks to continuity. So voicemails with AI summaries, hold assist, and call screening are all in the iPad 2, right on that big screen. With iPadOS 26, it really feels like Apple retooled things for those of you who wanted more out of your iPad for years, while leaving that classic iPad flair for anyone who wants to stick with what works for them. Liquid Glass makes the interface feel more alive. Windowing is finally worthy of the hardware, and files and preview erase years of friction. And the menu bar and background tasks mean you're finally in control, not the OS. The iPad will obviously always be a tablet at heart, but with iPadOS 26, it finally feels like a device you just trust to get things done without giving up what makes an iPad fun. If you've ever wanted a device that can keep up with your creativity, your hustle, and your weirdest side projects, this is it. Will it replace your laptop? For a lot of people, it absolutely can. For others, not yet. But for the first time, it actually feels like Apple is actually serious about making the iPad into a proper computer. Don't forget to enter our iPhone 17 Pro giveaway, and good luck to everyone who enters. Thanks for watching as always, guys. I appreciate your support. I'm Andrew Edwards, and I will catch you in the next video.